is South Africa. The bronze medal up for grabs.
Fabulous hands.
Love that. Tracy Nebel wins a bronze medal for the England Roses, and for the England fans, it was the right result. Looks like a few tears.
They would have won many more fans today, the Proteas.
Just 4 months after that bronze medal encounter in Liverpool, my goodness, time has flown. The England Roses have travelled to beautiful Cape Town for a rematch in the shadow of Table Mountain. Looks absolutely glorious. That's exactly where they are. Welcome to live coverage of the first of three tests between South Africa and England, live from the Cape Town Velodrome in South Africa. Good afternoon, and despite the wintry weather outside, there are new beginnings in the air for England netball. New management and lots of new faces putting on the red dress for this series. South Africa too have a change in coach and a hugely important 4 years ahead as they build up to the next World Cup on home soil in 2023. No fluctuations here in the studio though, as I'm delighted to be joined by a very familiar face in former England captain Pamela Cookie. Welcome, Pam.
How are you doing?
Good to see you. Out in Cape Town, the ever marvellous Caroline Barker will be giving us her regular updates. Speak to you very soon, Caroline. And it doesn't stop there. We're going interactive on netball today. Tamsin Greenway will also be giving us her view via Skype after welcoming her son into the world just last week. Tamsin, how are you?
I'm good. The joys of having a newborn. I'd forgotten 8 days in, but we're doing well.
Amazing. You look marvellous, doesn't she, Pam?
She does.
Amazing.
Great.
Who's babysitting at the moment?
I've got the Manny in, it's fine.
Brilliant.
Devil's far
excellent.
More important.
Excellent. Casey Jacks, gorgeous name as well. Before we find out what they're thinking, let's mark your cards for the weekend. In just under half an hour's time, the first centre pass, South Africa, England. Tomorrow, the second test is at 12:30 and a slightly earlier time on Sunday, 10:30 a.m. Three exciting games coming your way. Well, it's the start of a new four-year cycle. England Roses coming off the back of that third place finish at the World Cup. South Africa fourth. Of course, England beat them in that third, fourth place playoff. This three-match series, Pam, what are you hoping to see from the England Roses? Because we've got some new faces in there, haven't we?
Yeah, definitely. Well, we've got six Roses that we saw at the World Cup not here. Mentor, Osorio Brown, Guthrie, Pittman, H2, as you like to call them, Housby.
Housby. Love them.
Yeah, so they're missing. So this is a chance for England now to bed some newer players. We've got Jakeford Lewis coming into the squad in goal attack. We've seen how fab she has been in the Super League. So how will she perform on the international stage? I think what I really want to see in this tour is them being given opportunities, not just 5 minutes at the end of a game to come on, but really getting opportunities to play against international level netball.
Well, Tamsin's been waxing lyrical on social media about these three games. And I know you're very excited, Tamsin. What do you make of the squad that Jess has picked for this series?
I actually think it's quite a statement squad. You heard Pam talk about so many players missing and who they've brought into the mould. They've also taken some experience in there. You know, Laura Malcolm, Nat Panagari, they're the older player. They've been around for a little bit longer. Bringing Kate Shimmin into the squad, I know there was a lot of talk about that as well. So I too want to see some of these youngsters. I think for England now moving forward, we know that a lot of those players from World Cup will return at some point. But I think there's three key areas: the goalkeeper, the centre, and the goal shooter. And I'd love England to develop those positions here. So the likes of Fisher, for me, getting on court is really important. Raz Kwashi at the back. I think we've got to realistically look and go, who is going to be our long-term keeper? And I know they've got Stacey Francis in the squad, who we'll probably see play there. But for me, I think longer term, she's stronger out of goal defence, and I'd like to see who's going to take that role.
I read a couple of your articles because you're not returning my calls, so I had to read your articles. And you said that it's harder for a new shooter to come into the fold than a new defender. Just explain a little bit about that.
Yeah, look, there's a lot of pressure that comes into a goal shooter. And if you look at any of the shooting greats around the world, Janelle Fallied, Caitlin Bassett, Joe Harton, and, you know, Pam and I could talk about when we first started playing with Joe Harton. It's very different when you come in as a shooter because, you know, as a young 18-year-old, 19-year-old, 20-year-old, playing against some of those really experienced keepers like your Geitzy used to play against or Yashani Leighton, it's really hard to suddenly get out there and make a massive impact. You might have a good game and it might drop off a little bit. A defender's almost got nothing to lose. You know, I'm not saying it's any easier by any stretch of the imagination, but you can go on there and just be a hassler almost, learn the game as you're playing. So I think that's where England have really got to focus. We know that Nat Hawthornthwaite is going to take this England team forward, and amazing that she's been named captain. But this is a perfect opportunity for someone like Fisher to say, right, I am going to be the next shooter after Joe Hart, and give me a shot. Let me play out three series, get Corbin on there with her to give us some experience, and just make sure that these players don't miss this opportunity. Mm.
It is. It really is huge. Well, it's the first test in charge for the new England coach, Jess Thirlby. Caroline Barker caught up with her yesterday to find out exactly how she's feeling.
It feels a bit like Christmas Eve. I'm super excited. I kind of feel like we are stepping into the unknown a little bit in terms of like what this particular test series kind of has entailed for us. But yeah, I mean, I can't, how can I fault this? Like, I feel incredibly lucky. I absolutely love the game. And I'm working with a squad out here who, when we spoke the other day about the why are we here, and they each fed back, you know, the amount of people that just said, I just love it. And I feel like that's our kind of common ground with this group.
I imagine there's great disappointment from what happened at a home World Cup. How did you pick this team up?
I went with family and I watched as a super fan, and I've also watched it through the eyes of a coach. A lot's been spoken about kind of disappointment, and I don't feel that in the same way, I don't think, because I've been part of England squads either as a player or, you know, as part of a coaching team who have been in that third, fourth playoff a lot. And this bronze felt very, very different. Our sports profile has grown hugely in the last 3 or 4 years, and so the expectation does as well. And you can't hide anymore. And we're grateful for that. I think collectively, as a combination, achieving gold and then getting bronze in a home World Cup was huge. And I think together, that was a massive achievement and by far the greatest of an England team to date. I guess I'm driven by trying to maintain but also build on that momentum and success. So, if anything, there's an outstanding piece here. You know, like, England have never made a World Cup final, so somebody's got to take the team. I guess I just said, why not me? You know, I've worked with England senior squads. I've toured several times. There's a lot about the role where I feel really well prepared.
But have you had that moment where you've gone, right, I didn't expect that?
Have I had that moment? Most probably when I got the phone call to say that I've got the job. To kind of hear somebody say that they want you to lead your country, it's just an incredible moment. So I think from that point, it was just, wow, like, let's get going. You know, we've got a World Cup to make. And people talk a lot that 4 years is a long time, and it really isn't.
What would be success from this weekend for South Africa?
I think you've got two teams that are entering a little bit of an unknown space. You know, both teams have not got players that they had in Liverpool, and for very good reason. You know, I think I've been quite vocal about that. You know, whilst I appreciate the fans want to see those names that have become more household, Serena, Joe, Helen Housby, Jeeva Mentor, I totally understand that. But in order for us to be the best team we can be and go one better in a couple of years' time, we have to broaden the base of players, and we need to expose players to the likes of test series like this. We believe that we've got a team strong enough to get the win out here. South Africa have got a bit more continuity from Liverpool. So although they've had some formal retirements, we've only got four that are actually here from that squad. You've got players like an Ellie Cardwell, a George Fisher, a Raz Kwashi. They've been around this group for the last year or two, and they're kind of really hungry now to take their opportunity. But to expect maybe consistency and seamlessness across these three games is most probably unrealistic. But what they won't be lacking is passion, pride, and they've got a real respect for one another in this group.
Come the World Cup in 2023, are you going to be here hanging a gold medal over your neck?
I believe so. I believe this England team have every ability to go on to do better than they've ever done before. And rather than be a supporter in the stands, I wanted to be part of that.
It's a new era for England netball and the first game since the World Cup. This is the starting seven. Pam, what do you make of the seven players she's chosen?
I like it. I think Jess has gone for a bold start. She's strong. She's gone for experience to kick this game off, this test series off, I think. And that's really crucial in terms of giving the players confidence. You've got Jay Clark in the middle, the most capped England player ever. You couldn't get more experience than that. And then Nat Hawthornthwaite coming in as a new captain at wing attack. She is going to make this position her own. She needs to, and lead this squad from the front. And I like to see Ellie Cardwell in at goal shooter. Again, she finished off the Super League really well. Can she continue that momentum in that attacking end?
Yeah, she's gone for that experience, hasn't she, with Jade? 169 caps to her name at the moment, 170 today. Tamsin, Stacey Francis is a really interesting talking point, isn't she? She stepped away from the game a couple of years ago, is back in the fold. Didn't think she could contend for a starting spot, but she's in there. What kind of talent, what kind of strength does she bring to the side?
Well, I think there's been a lot of chat about Stacey Francis and why she hasn't been in the squad. And I think she made some decisions to pull away from that. And she's probably never been that starting player. She's been so successful down under for the past couple of seasons, playing in Perth, playing for West Coast Fever. And I think that style that she's picked up out there has been really effective. The thing for me is where she's playing. You know, they're putting her in at goalkeeper. Is that her strongest position? No, I don't think so. Goal defence is her strongest position. But when you talk about experience, and that's what I said about statement squad, having someone like Francis in there who is not only incredible on the court but off the court as well will make wonders for someone like Fran Williams. And before they went out on tour, I was speaking to Fran and she was saying, you know, when you play with Stacey, you just know what's happening. You know, she'll go on stuff, she'll be calling things. And as a young player, you want that confidence.
Yeah, so the Roses haven't had much time to practice with each other, but you like that combination as well. You were nodding when Tamsin was saying that, the Fran and Stacey combination, goalkeeper, goal defence.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's, as T was saying, that experience that Stacey brings, yes, she hasn't probably been, when she wasn't in the squad, that first pick goal defence or goalkeeper, but at the back, she's going to give Fran that confidence. And Fran is so smart. And together, Stacey's a great, smart player as well. So they'll be working well together in terms of shutting down those shooters. So, no, I really do like that. And I think Fran will come on leaps and bounds with Stacey behind her.
Oh, so much to talk about in the next couple of hours. But straight after the break, we'll be speaking about South Africa. And they were on top of the world, on top of Table Mountain earlier this week. There's Bongi, all smiles. No doubt she'll be playing centre, putting on that bib very shortly. Do they have home advantage? Will it play a massive role? We'll see you in a mo. It's England-South Africa, a three-match series. First centre passes at 5 o'clock. The England team arriving at the Belleville Velodrome. slight height difference between the two sides, but as Jess Philby said in a press conference, England bring different skills and different qualities to their side. Well, the South African team have been picked. Let's have a look at their starting seven. And a real mixture of quite a lot of experience in their side. 9 of the 15 training squad were part of the Netball World Cup in Liverpool in July. This is the starting seven. Pam, over to you. Yeah. What strength do you see?
Well, first up, a goal shooter, Lenise Potgieter. She is their go-to girl at goal shooter. Alongside Bongi Mosomi, we thought maybe we would see her at centre.
Surprised to see her at wing attack.
Yeah, but she's been playing that. She was playing that at the World Cup. They brought in Roman Dreyer at centre. She's been with Badenhurst, the head coach at NWU. So they've got experience of working together. So potentially that's what she's seeing in terms of bringing her into there. Shadeen van der Meer at goal defence. Again, we normally see her at wing defence, but we're seeing her at goal defence. Again, just to give that little bit of strength in that defensive end to work alongside Pumza Mweni, I think.
Tamsin, I have a feeling that you're going to be disappointed that Bongi's playing starting wing attack position. You want to see her in centre.
I actually prefer Bongi in centre. I always at Surrey Storm, that's where she played. When I brought her into Wasps, that's where she played in that first season. I think it's quite an interesting start from South Africa, because I talked before they went into the series, you know, they knew they weren't having any Pretorius, which is a massive loss for them. So putting in van der Merwe there, but moving across from wing defence, they're almost shifting positions around to fit certain players on court, where I just thought they'd probably strengthen it. You know, give a new goal defence a shot, because you know you're getting Pretorius back at some point. Perhaps put Bongi in the middle and give Grizel a chance at wing attack, because we saw her play at the World Cup. I actually think that's quite an interesting lineup. But as Pam said, when coaches have relationships with players, and that's where I'm going off with Bongi and Somi, you know, you get to a point where you prefer them in certain positions.
OK, well, speaking of new coaches, South Africa have a new coach, and Lenise Potgieter has been speaking about the change in management and what a difference it does make at the top.
We definitely respect our new coaches and management coming in, but the respect we had for Norma and Nicole was just so much, because we were basically nowhere, and we actually, at that stage, where countries like New Zealand, Australia and England and Jamaica actually fear us when they come up against us. So that's just amazing, and that's the respect we got from Norma. But the process to get us back on track is going to maybe take a while. Hopefully the players that was with Norma can help with those transitioning and helping the younger ones, but it is going to take a time. But I'm still very, like, hopeful for this team. Like, the way we've been training, even though we just get less than a week to train together, we're still doing an amazing job, I think.
The Plum era, Norma Plummer being in charge of South Africa, she made such a massive difference, Pam. As she said, she farmed players out to different countries for them to gain international experience. She's broadened the spectrum of player in South Africa and created such a legacy. A difficult job for Dorette Badenhurst to take over from her. What do you think of what Lenise just said there?
Definitely. Well, she didn't seem too confident, did she?
Not really, in that
statement, but I think Coach Plum, she is a phenomenon, and the respect that she has from players all over the country that she's worked with, especially the South Africa team as well, she made them fearless. Just that connotations with them, but how she worked with them and that mental capability that they gave them. But at the same time, the new coaches have worked with Norma. That's been the plan all along in terms of creating that legacy. She's improved the breadth of players, but also the breadth of coaches. So it's still got an influence of Plum in there. So I think that's where South Africa need to just take that from.
Well, speaking of Potgieter, we saw her in the World Cup and she was absolutely brilliant. Tamsin, what do you make of the shooting circle, the starting circle, when they've got Stoltz and Potgieter playing together, starting together?
Yeah, well, I think, look, Potgieter, we know what she brings to the game. She was lethal at World Cup. I think even Mentor struggled at times to get to grips with that ball over the top. It's going to be about the delivery. We've seen Renske's goals in the Super League. We've seen her at Fast Five. We know she's a long bomb shooter. Whether she can get to grips with shooting over the top of Fran Williams, that's where she sometimes struggles. So that partnership will be building. And I'm guessing that's why they've stuck Bongi and Somi there, to try and help with that feed and help with that delivery, because she's very used to putting that ball over the top. We've seen that relationship with Rachel Dunn as well. So, yeah, really interesting. I think her comments, Potheater, you can see what a confident player she is in that squad now. She was talking about those youngsters coming through, and to even make those sort of comments about the coaching setup, you know what a key player she is in that side. And for South Africa to be successful in these three test series, they need her firing, but it's going to be about how they deliver to her.
Mm. Comes with age, doesn't it? You become more vocal. She wouldn't have said it a few years ago.
When your position's solid as well.
Yes, you know, because you've nailed that starting position, haven't you? Well, we mentioned Caroline Barker. She's out in South Africa. She's at the Velodrome. Caroline, over to you. What's happening?
Hello, Di. Hello, Pam. Yeah, sure, we got the beautiful views, we got the weather, but it's not the same without you. Cape Town is a party, though, as England take on South Africa. I know you'll have spoken about the fact that this is a rematch, a grudge match after that bronze medal match, but these two very different sides, there's strength in that South Africa side, though. You look at the team, those 9 out of the 15 that they brought here to Cape Town have that experience of the World Cup. They've just won the African Cup too, and their coach is confident they can take this England team all the way and win this series. As for Jess Thirlby, she says it just happens that the team she's picked, that starting seven for this first match in the test, has all that experience, that quality, those caps through it. But she's ready to make that blend and ready to start a new era for the England Roses. We are expecting it to be a sellout. They love the noise here. They love the atmosphere too. So all of that will be very much the same as back home. And you know what? Some things never change. I think round about here, I've got some sweets still. Enjoy it.
That's why we miss you.
No.
Caroline, why aren't you here with the sweets? Fantastic to hear from you. And very shortly, the first centre pass will get underway. To remind you, these two captains know each other inside out. Let's hear from them now.
Well, I remember hearing that you were coming to Wasps and I was so excited because I'd seen you play for Surrey Storm. And I just loved the way you played. And then when I met you, I was just like, you're just a bundle of joy. And just wanted to cuddle you all the time. I think the beauty of your game is you just play with such freedom and you play the game how you want to play it. And I think that's just amazing because you lift everybody else around you. If I threw a ball, you would always be on the end of it. You would just always be on the end of it. Even if it wasn't the best ball, you make a bad ball look good. And yeah, you just...
No, but there was no... It was always, you know, on point. It comes from you. It had to be on point. Then I had to go. I think I always loved watching her playing, loved playing with her as a teammate. One of the smartest wing attacks I've ever seen. When I heard that she was obviously named the captain, in my head straight away, I just thought of the Natalie on court that I played with, and I could see this happening. There was no other better person. And yesterday, obviously, her first speech I've heard her for the first time talking. I was like, yes, this is what I thought in my head. I think she deserves it. She's just a great leader. It'll be good to see her grow, obviously, in the leadership role as well.
South Africa are a team that don't give up much ball at all. They very much keep possession and a very possession-based team. And so we're definitely going to have to do our homework on how we're going to try and, shut that down and shut this one down.
The Vitality Roses will hustle hard for the ball, and when they get the ball, I think the transition into their goal third is very quick. If we lose the ball, if it happens, it does happen in the game, then we have to really step up quickly to be in position, otherwise they just run through. It's going to be a tough battle. There's no other better competitive team that we could get to come home and really give us a good run.
For us, it's the start of a new four-year cycle. We've got a new coach, we've got some new faces in the group, and we've just got a group full of potential. The buzz about playing for your country, the buzz about being a Vitality Rose is just so exciting, and wanting to do the country proud and the dress proud and just play for each other. So, yeah, we would definitely love to win on the weekend, and we'll be doing all we can to achieve that.
To win this series will mean so much. It'd be so great to know that we have so much depth, especially after losing two experienced players in Mareka and Aaron. And for me, it'd be great to see what I can bring into the team, obviously, in building these young ones up. I cannot imagine any other great feeling than on Sunday, should we be announced, obviously, the winners of the series, because that will give so much confidence into the girls, and we want that going towards all the preparations for the World Cup that we're going to host. We need to offer something great for South Africans.
Welcome to the first test live from the Cape Town Velodrome. It's South Africa against England. The first of a three-match series. This is the starting lineup for the South African side. Pam, I've heard from you a moment ago. Let's head to Tamsin Greenway, who's joining us via Skype. And Pam, that centre position, we expected Bongi to start it. Tamsin, Rome Dryer, tell us a little bit about her and what she'll bring to the side.
Well, she's been working with the coach, so the coach knows her pretty well. And obviously feels more comfortable there. Look, I'm a personal fan of Bongi Mthombeni in the middle, but let's not forget that for South Africa, she's been the wing attack and the starting wing attack for the last 4 years with Erin Burger playing in the middle. So it's not really a shock change, but I think just looking at the squad and the people they're bringing in, you would have thought that, you know, she could have cemented that centre position. But it's more going to be about who's feeding Lunise Potgieter. And I think that's why they've gone for that, because Mthombeni will let ball go.
Moving on to the England starting seven. Pam, we've got experience in there, haven't we, with the likes of Jade Clark, we've got Fran Williams, Nat Panagari, who we saw in the World Cup, Nat Haythornthwaite, she's captaining the side. In terms of Nat Haythornthwaite, I know you and Tamsin are massive fans already. She is a whirlwind of energy, activity. What does she provide to the side, and how unselfish is she when she plays?
Oh, that's it, that unselfishness, as you just said. When I play with her, she makes other people look good. She will work and work and work and give you opportunities and give you balls to put you in the right position. And because she's played goal attack as well, as a wing attack, she understands where the shooters want the ball. So she's a great link-up player, and she will work her butt off on defence as well.
Tamsin, have you spoken to Nat Haythornthwaite?
Yeah, we've had a few chats, although I try to talk netball and she just wants to talk babies, which is hilarious.
Oh.
But look, Nat is a real confidence player, and I think giving her the captaincy was a really smart move, because, you know, you've given her full of belief now. She plays with so much flair and openness, and if they allow her to play the style she wants to play and lead that attack end, England will not only be lethal in this series, but they will be moving forward.
Well, these are live shots from the Velodrome, and the first centre pass is about to happen, and the national anthems have just happened, I believe. It's all set, and it's a sellout here at the Velodrome. Don't forget, South Africa, the destination for the 2023 World Cup. We're looking at the starting sevens again. Stacey Francis, as we mentioned, back in the fold. Fran Williams in that goal defence position. What do you make of the defence for England, Pam?
I really like it in terms of having Stacey at the back. We normally see her as a goal defence, and I think that's her better position. But being at the back, able to help Fran develop, I think is really good. She'll be talking to her, she'll be calling the shots. They'll be working as a really smart, clever partnership.
Of course, it's a squad of 12, and I'm sure in the next 30 minutes or so we'll be seeing a rotation, we'll be seeing different players on court. It's a chance, these three matches, to try out players, Tamsin, in positions that they may not have tried before.
Yeah, well, looking at that, Mweni in at goalkeeper, she's not got her partner in crime, so she's got Van der Merwe in there, who we usually see at wing defence. So whether she can actually stop that England attack end will be quite interesting to see. But South Africa mixing it up too.
First centre pass about to happen. Let's head straight to commentary.
Roses that start with ball in hand. There's Panagari. Fires that ball in, just looking for Ellie Cardwell. And already we see the spring and the elevation and the urgency from Corbin that we expect.
Yeah, Corbin, really dynamic goal attack there for the English Roses. Had a chat to her at the dinner the other night, and she said, you know, she's so good to be back. She's so excited to wear that red dress. And she's up against our Shadeen van der Merwe. Interesting to see what Shadeen will do against the Corbin, because we've seen Shadeen on the wing defence position for the spot approach here. So she's now replacing Katla Mostert, of course, in that goal defence position.
Lovely feed-in from Dreyer. One of those changes for Van der Merwe, perhaps. Maybe not expected, but such strength. And there's the smile. Quick feed again from the centre pass for England. Captain Haythornthwaite was calling for it, moving around the circle. Corbin to settle her.
Yeah, she's going to make sure. Corbin needs to make sure with those, especially from that distance, she needs to convert those goals for her side.
Oh, well, we were expecting defensive pressure and we got it.
Hold time.
Yeah, Pumza Maweni. She took some time off, didn't play the Africa Cup. She's back, she was recovering from an injury, and we heard the coach saying that, no, she's playing very good netball at this moment, and she's going to be key for the Spa Proteas in that defensive circle.
Maweni herself experienced, played for Seven Stars, Loughborough Lightning in the UK. It's England
again, the early stages of this one in Cape Town. The first of three match series, and hug the post she might. She might need its help today.
Oh, great to see this crowd erupting. You know, they were quite quiet in that match, in the curtain raiser match, but they're here to watch the big guns, and definitely must say,
oh, look at that transition from South Africa. Msomi always an option, but they go back, and Msomi again very much part of this South Africa team, their captain. Francis saying hello once again, it's been a while.
Yeah, she's back. She's been away. She's back, and she's making her presence really known and felt.
That is great goal, isn't
South that? Africa ahead, and their centre pass. Just put an early two-goal run on. Oh, gate battling then from the England team. Clark combining with Panagari. Goes back to Fran Williams, Super League winner with Wasps, and out to the edge of the circle. Pirouette.
Goalkeeper, arms around.
On that circle.
Step forward, keep
umpires up. Want to clear that up early on, just as they're getting a measure of each other.
England!
So they're even surprised by the way we're just seeing things in that centre pass, particularly at the moment.
Yeah, well, I'm looking at, you know, the goal attack in Corbin. You know, she's playing more on the wing attack side, and she's fetching those centre passes. I was expecting more, you know, the captain to be the one driving as an attacking player to take those centre passes. But this is their set play, and they're actually executing it very well, is the English Roses.
Oh, the fake.
Keeper, will you actually
see, we forward. Love that watching on, as long as it comes off. Players. Step in from
Poppy.
She's so calm anywhere under that post.
No, she is very, very good. And I mean, you know, we played at the World Cup Bandage against the English Roses. You guys had Jeeva Mentor in that goalkeeper position.
Bandage,
and she gave Lenise quite a hard time. So let's see what Francis has in store for Port Gifter tonight.
Great splits from Cardwell. That one just falls short. They're on the rebound. Moeni, little slap of the hand. She felt just perhaps could have got something from that.
This is good defense from the English Roses, though. I love the hands up, 3 feet away, putting all that pressure, forcing the spar protest to play it right back. Not an easy entry into that shooting circle.
Contact center.
Just causing that pressure around the circle edge, too. South Africa get the call at the moment. Msomi working out the puzzle.
Position goal attack.
Msomi put the ball just over the top. And everywhere I look in Cape Town over the past few days, Zanlele, it's been all about the Rugby World Cup. And it's getting a bit like that in the circle at the moment.
Yeah, and we know how that turned out.
Oh, go away.
No, we're not going to go there. We're focusing on netball now.
Yeah, loads of body on body at international level. Back tie.
Contact goal defense.
Corbin again, just off the back.
Yeah, Redeker doing well to clean up that ball.
Wing attack.
Just all the time that contact happening through court, just trying to delay South Africa. Quick
that
feet,
contact
from Msomi. Great upper body strength. And Pogita able to roll around and find that space.
Yeah, that was a good feed from Ramey Dreyer. First time getting a starting opportunity for the Spar Protea, so really making use of it, being clinical.
Again, has a look around the corner, finds Renske Stoltz. Seen her shoot from that range before in fast fives. But when she's got a backup, a teammate like that, just to gobble the ball up under the post.
Yeah, absolutely. But Renske's going to have to take those shots. She's capable of shooting from that distance. She cannot be looking for Lenise. She's there as a help shooter. Goal attack to assist her goal shooter.
Obstruction. Yes.
Super League winner. Cardwell settles in the game. Been impressed what you've seen from her inside that circle already?
Yeah, absolutely. As a young player, you know, she's strong. She's really giving you know, Pumza Maweni a lot to think about there. She's creative. I love the fact that she picks her up very nicely, solid anchoring and very strong, accurate as well. So that's what you need from a goal shooter.
I mean, there's some ridiculous skill going on up the other end for South Africa in that attacking circle. But now they'll try and defend this Roses centre pass again. Haythornthwaite combines with Kadeen Corbin. Back to Nat Haythornthwaite. Maweni was on the fly. I think, Zanella, you went with her then.
Yeah, I did, actually. And I'm so glad she actually picked it up. Now she's sending a message to England that, you know, she's aware of those balls outside the circle and she'll definitely go out and hunt for them. She might not have gotten that one, but she's definitely going to go out for a couple of more.
And immediately, if you're an attacker, you're thinking she'll be there and you doubt yourself.
And that's why it's important for a goalkeeper to guard for those balls, you know, to sort of confuse the attackers. Now they'll think twice before they feed those balls into the pocket.
Bandage offside, Wade.
Fluid from England initially, but again, good defensive pressure.
Crowd didn't like that.
Yes.
So they wanted that decision.
No, back where she was. Yes.
Lovely little ball in and good take from Cardwell.
South Africa.
And they've got it back to within one. Keep swinging out to the two goal difference. And South Africa, we've seen this before, just put the pressure on the opposition. But there, great movement from Corbin, irritating around and gets the ball.
Brilliant, as a goal attack, taking that ball.
Manage instruction, wing defense, center contact.
Now England are on the attack. Jade Clark finding the circle's edge.
Probably in England. Manage offside, wing defense. Contact goal defense, where you are.
That final ball in then as well, just splitting those two defensive options for South Africa. Back level again.
Oh, there she is again, Maweni. She's seeing those balls. Just her angle there, you know, just a little bit the back of the goal attack, but she's reading them. So England just need to be awake and aware.
Reminder, this is the first of three in this test series to be played Saturday and Sunday to come, slightly earlier times both those days. But both these sides with new coaches, some changes in combinations, looking really to prove their worth ahead of the Nations Cup come January as well. Good line from Panagari. There was a yell from Clark, and Williams comes to help him back up. Corbin too, doing a lot of work down court. You get the mobility from Kadeen Corbin.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, she's playing, sort of playing like an extra wing attack there. On the attack for the English Roses, doing well too. Can see Cardwell encouraging her teammates, telling them, let's go, guys.
Centre pass again.
My goodness, that was beautiful from Kadeen Corbin. Just drew Shadeen Fanamava out of that circle and took that space, landing right under the pole.
She's a dangerous player when she's smiling.
So how can we get her to be frowning?
I think you've got the skills. The Stokes, again, just
confidence
for Stokes maybe to put that shot up.
And this is what I said, you know, she needs to have the confidence, she needs to back herself. She can shoot from that distance. She's constantly playing out or looking for Potgieter. And the defenders are smart enough to pick that up. But she does convert that one.
Renske Stoltz, who shot the winning points in Fast Five a couple of years ago in the UK. Got herself a contract in the Super League.
Contact centre.
I mean, that was gentle, wasn't it? Would you have stood up to that?
Where you are, centre.
You know, I don't want to even comment about umpires' calls. Lest I get into trouble. They are the professionals. They call it the way they see it.
We got three games. I'll get it out of you.
I still want to keep
where
my job, you know.
Step back. Thank you.
And again, just the
South
settle
Africa.
From Cardwell. So when you've got that liveliness in there of Corbin, good combination that end. So it's about seeing a bit more work maybe for South Africa in that attacking end in that combination.
Contact wing defence.
Must say I'm very impressed with the England defensive setup here, especially in this goal third. They're putting so much pressure on the Spa Proteas that the ball is not getting into Lenice as smooth and as quickly. They're forcing them to play back, sometimes even to the center third. And that's a better effort again from Stoltz. I think her confidence is growing.
Those are thoughts of Stanella here with us in the commentary position in Cape Town, and that's just going to make you another foot taller.
Bad distraction, Gold Tech.
Yeah, I'm going to be a foot taller if South Africa can convert this ball.
Contact when your fans are
I'm sensing it, that red wall appears in front of them.
It's a good screen set up there in the shooting circle. Yeah, I know she's a tough cookie. She must get up and continue with the business after night.
Is that not how you say hello?
Sort of asking her, do you remember me?
You will. So that is the real ability of Lenny Cogito then. Just not a care in the world putting that shot up.
Contact Old Tech.
Under 3 minutes of this first quarter. Good take. Williams around.
Contact arm, goalkeeper. Step with her, goalkeeper. That's it. Your arm. Strikes from both players.
Gita readjusts her feet. Everyone stands and watches. And you can see why she's got that contract with the Adelaide Thunderbirds. Gained just the real strength and off to play in Australia again. Up the other end. Here come England again. Oh, the fast ball in. Strength behind that. Straight into the chest of Jay Clark. And Clark combining with Williams. Forcing their way through that South Africa defence. But into the wrong hands. Corbin Giff wraps it.
Wow, that was brilliant play from England. The way they were swinging that ball around that circle's edge. But South Africa, Wani Gwenika able to get that ball. Romay doing very well there, Dreyer, to keep that ball in court.
Keep your heads, because that was almost press repeat, wasn't it? England give it away one end. South Africa nearly give it away the other, but still have the ball.
Conte, goalkeeper.
Ooh, yeah, no, that was really good from Francis.
With her outside.
It was a quick crawl, wasn't it?
Yeah, quick off the mark.
Oh, Stoltz. Well, we've been asking her to put the shot up. She puts it up, and it ends in England hands.
Obstruction in the
time. Oh, they're playing on the edge, England. This time, though, through the net.
South Africa.
That was brilliant from England. Love the way they quickly picked up that a shooter. The shooter was open on the left-hand side and played that ball down court.
Stoltz comes out for it this time. Well, there's the pressure from the defence, and then when you've got to think about where it's going, I mean, I'd still be tying my shoelaces, but it just puts her off.
With me, come back.
So my question is, what is the defensive pattern here from the Spa Proteas at the moment? I'm not really quite seeing what it is. Are they man-to-man? Is it more, you know, area defense? Because it's clearly visible with the Roses that they're shutting down every player and forcing the Spa Proteas to be called for held ball.
So Zanella, as we approach the last few seconds of this quarter, is that an area you'd change up?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you've got to pick up that, you know, are the Roses quick off the mark? Are you able to stay man on man, or can you put more of a zone defense and then make that decision as a team? But it needs to be a unit when it comes to defense. You cannot do, you know, run on your own individual pattern.
Well, there goes the hooter. South Africa swung themselves ahead, but England clawed them back, and it was just that consistency from England at the end that just gives them the narrow lead as we head into the second quarter. England then with the advantage.
Very tight between these two sides. What a first 50 minutes we've seen. Ellie Cardwell showing us what she's worth, and Kadeen Corbin settling in the second quarter, coming up in just a couple of minutes' time, live from South Africa. A close match so far, the first 15 minutes. Pam, what have you seen from the England Roses side? It's 15-12 at the moment to England.
Yeah, South Africa had come back and then England would go ahead again. South Africa would crawl it back, so it's been a tight first quarter. But from England, I really loved how Kadeen Corbin has grown into that court this quarter. She started off a bit nervy. She missed her first shot and I think her second one as well. But then she just sparked. And that's what you can get from Kadeen in terms of how she comes up the court to bring the ball and then drives to the post. I'm loving Ellie Cardwell. I know I talk about my shooters, but... she was really good hold. She's coming off the body and she's turning to post.
Yeah, and that combination with Nat Haythornthwaite is working really well. Let's get straight back to commentary in South Africa.
At 15 at the Bellville Velodrome at Cape Town. And England with the narrow lead then at quarter time. But it was very much, Zanella, South Africa that came out with that intention. And they had a couple of times when there were two goals in front, but England just defensively worked on them.
Yeah, I think the defensive setup and unit from the English Roses was really solid in this first quarter. And I hope the coach of the Spartans has picked it up and really can whisper in the ear of Renske Stoltz that, you know what, she needs to start coming to the game now, being confident in converting those goals for the Spartans. You see that the coach has kept her on, so there hasn't been a change where they got attack position for the Spartans.
And for the England Roses, just in that huddle again, they've shown that real quality at one end. We've had a couple of times when you've seen that excitement from Kadeen Corbin.
Yeah, I think Kadeen Corbin is still warming up. There she is again, fetching that centre pass for the English Roses.
So this is the first of the three-match series. England with that three-goal advantage heading into this second quarter. Jade Clark, who's most capped player, one of those that was at the World Cup, of course, one of four in this England squad that were part of that bronze medal match.
Shortening, moving in
Liverpool.
Yeah, a bit awkward there from Cardwell, but did well. You can see her face expression. Did well, controlled her body well there.
Former South Africa captain, Zanele Dandana, alongside me. Just watching some of this younger players being blooded in. We've seen a change as well at wing defence.
Yeah, we've seen a change from the Spar Proteas. They've brought in Kanyisa Chawana on the wing defence position.
And that's a player for an England to watch out for, because she'll be heading to the Super League to play for Team Bath, the fourth South African player to make that journey to Team Bath the next Super League season. She's played a couple of quarters against Australia at the World Cup. She's shown real strength too to come on. Talking of strength, there's exhibit A in that circle.
Yeah, so there was a lot of talk about, you know, Harton being not here, Harsby not being here, and what will Cardwell do. I think she's really doing a phenomenal job in that shooting circle for England. Really solid and really giving Phumza Maweni asking her a lot of questions at this point in time.
Just having a little pause on court, there's some sweat. I mean, sweat up here. If they want to bring the towel up here too, I'll take it.
I've been looking for the remote control for the aircon. Found it.
We're not complaining. We're in a velodrome in Cape Town. The sea is lapping outside. The sun has been beating down for the past few days. And at the moment, we're watching proper international netball. Two teams going toe-to-toe. Two teams that believe they can be, come the World Cup here in South Africa in 2023, they believe they can be up the top of those world rankings.
Seeing Lenise Borghita coming to fetch that ball right out of the shooting circle. We don't see that often. It speaks to the defense that the Roses are putting up.
I tell you what, if she doesn't want to put the shot up, Renske Stoltz, the pass will do. Finding her teammate. Oh, Kadeen Corbin. Should we sign her up as a defender?
Yeah, this is good work there from Kadeen and Shadeen Fanamadva. Kadeen.
It's a new pop group. It's not going to happen.
Construction. Goal attack. Where you are. Footwork.
Well.
Far side.
Footwork. She has quick feet. I'm still trying to drag you out to say something about the umpires. But that.
Yes, keep up.
That call. She at least was not happy about that, Drea.
You are not going to catch me out. I am so alert. I'm so awake when it comes to that. That's why I chose to be a player and a coach, not an umpire.
There's always time. Four goal lead now for England. Still early in this second quarter.
Out of hands, contact out of hands. Yes. Where you are.
South Africa captain Bongi Mosomi. Great little fake. And the feed in to Pogita. Francis with the obstruction call. No matter to Lise Pogita. Haythornthwaite having to go
bad
over the top.
Bad wing defence. Bad obstruction. Whole time. Wing defence, there's a little unintentional contact. It's a caution, no, it's outside.
Caution there. Is that fear on the faces of those in the crowd at the moment? Not used to, particularly in this arena, seeing their South Africa team behind. But, oh, there you go.
Shadeen Fanamera, welcome. She's filling in those shoes in that goal defence position, replacing Kadla Mostert for Pretorius, who's currently just taking a break and recovering, but doing a phenomenal job there in combination with Phumza Maweni.
Hold time. When you defence, you're moving off. Next time it's a delay. Back where you are.
Nat Panagari and the umpire having a talking to. South Africa just shutting it out. Oh, that one couldn't stick.
Very lucky to get that opportunity again, the Spa Proteas.
Chance to reset. But the problem is, everywhere you look at the moment, and Williams appointing Case, just seeing those Roses arms come in. Good movement again from England. Clark trying to find a way. Who was there?
Shadeen. She says, not under my watch.
What a few months she's having. And she's a little bit fortunate. Unfortunate for others with injuries. She's got that move again to Australia and just really shining.
Yeah, I could actually see that. I don't know if she was wanting to pass that to Cardwell or she was actually attempting to take a shot.
What
Corbin,
would you, what would you rather that be put down as? A pass or a shot? Never mind, at the other end, South Africa again, another real opportunity to pull one back. Oh, but still Pogita, the advantage she had is her arms are about 7 foot longer.
Yeah, I think what she's doing well there, Pogita, for me, you know, she's positioning in front of Francis, not giving an opportunity, you know, to contest the over ball. We're seeing her pulling out of the circle as well. Let's see if Stoltz can back herself here.
Contact. She's got it. It's out of her hands. Where you are, goal attack.
Francis just stands to the side. It probably was, to be fair to Stoltz, just too far out for that. And again, the pass squirts. Perhaps got to take a little bit of the load off Pogita. Working at the moment, though, South Africa were down in that first quarter by 3 goals. They pulled it back to a goal. Now putting that defensive pressure on. That change seems to be working on wing defence.
Yeah, Kanyisa Chawane, we normally see her on an attacking position, centre wing attack, but you know, you put her anywhere and she'll do the job for you. That's a great pressure put on there by the Spa Proteas, turning that ball. Can they make use of it to draw level?
A couple of votes for this side. Sensing perhaps Jay Clark tries to get some fingers in on the action. South Africa still have it. Stoltz, good work from her coming out from the circle. And that just split that England defence, and that was clever.
Yeah, you know, she's got the split, and it takes her literally right under that pole. It's virtually impossible to defend that ball to Potgieter.
Back level, 18-all. So much more netball to come. Exhausting at the moment. The adrenaline that's going through, and now South Africa going out.
Yeah, I know. You can see the girls have just gone up a level. Just gone up a gear. They're trying to put their foot on the accelerator. Crowd is erupting. We're looking at those goal shoot percentages, 86% there for Pogita and 66% for Stoltz.
This could be a big goal for Corbin. That had height, that had precision. Just seeing the president of Netball South Africa sat in the crowd.
That is instruction.
Had the pleasure to meet Cecilia Mokwale a little bit earlier in the week. So proud of this team, and she'll be proud of this performance at the moment.
Yeah, just catching Williams with the eyes down there. Very smart from Stoltz, releasing that ball to Potgieter.
Contact with the fence. Dodge offside, obstruction centre.
Corbin a little closer. Just rolls around, but Cardwell with that range manages to pop that in. We've seen Cardwell previously in the closing stages of the Super League when Manchester Thunder were going for the title. She has that calmness under that post, as does Bongi Mosomi, showing on court her wing defence position.
Growing.
I don't know if that's pain or happiness.
That is causing wing attack. Contact goal attack.
Fran Williams for England, what do you make of her style? Because she's quite unassuming. She's not sort of the loudest that we see on court.
Very unassuming, but very effective. She's got the height and she's a thinker. You can see she understands the goal defence position very well. And she's putting a lot of pressure on Renske at the moment. And I love the fact that she, you know, she's sort of silenced Renske, but she's also assisting Francis there to sort of defend Lenise Borgitte.
Contact. Hand forward.
So quick. And you know both these sides well, having seen the change in coaches, have you been impressed with the way that South Africa, has it been seamless?
No, I think Dorette Barnhorst and coach Dumisani Chauke are doing a phenomenal job. They haven't been in office for long, you know, and that is a very hot seat with Norma Plummer being the coach that coached the SPAR Proteas, leaving them on such a high level. The standard was quite high, you know, but I think the SPAR Proteas are continuing with that level of excellence, and I think we can really be proud with the work that Dorette Barnhorst and Dumisani Chauke are doing.
Just a little loose ball from South Africa. Very much. Yep. The pressure that's being put on at the moment by this England team. A tumble on court.
So impressed with the mobility and agility of Cardwell in that shooting circle. You know, she's tall, but she's creative. She doesn't only just stand, you know, she moves and she's very agile.
Interesting, because we see Pumsa Mweni at 187 centimeters and Cardwell in there 188, so they're matching up height-wise, and yet there was a question put to Jess Thirlby, the England coach this week, about how small perhaps she thought this England team were standing up on court.
Hold time. Goal circle.
Just asking for a little wipe of the ball.
And they change it,
we are in the middle of a velodrome, so there's quite a runoff, isn't there, from the court, but the noise still coming from the crowd, even though they are just a little bit further away. All mod cons. I'll tell you how long's left. 4:45 in this half. Good land from there. Movement again from Poppy.
Yeah, brilliant there from Renske. I love the way she was sweeping that front of the circle, just pulling one defender, opening up Borgitte.
That is great goal attack. That is contact on your leg. Found obstruction centre.
Mweni just trying to get some hands in again, an unsettled Cardwell.
Yes.
Jay Clark. With the opportunity for England. So Hathorn Thwaite on the edge of the circle, swings it back over to Clark. And Corbin had her head down, was on the run, and finishes
South
it off.
South Africa!
South Africa centre pass. Two goals just nibbled ahead again by England.
That is offside.
That's good work from Captain Mwangi Mosomi. I think the precisions on the feeds from Dreya to Fortitude really, it's making sense now. It's coming together nicely. She was a little bit rattled in the first quarter of this game. She's finding her feet, finding her confidence.
Oh, there go the crowd now.
Yep, Pumsa Mweni doing well to turn that ball.
And that really, for coaches, that's the point in which, what do you, well, you as a coach, having been the player, so you understand both sides. Well, actually, maybe you don't understand the players now.
What are you doing? Listen, that's the coach's nightmare. He just worked so hard to turn the ball. You know, you just need to take a deep breath, just play it short patiently.
Back up to two goals, 22-24. 2 minutes 45 of this one remaining. Two great quarters to come. This in a three-match series, of course. The final few minutes of this quarter. Stacey Francis, she gets the call too.
Yeah, and she was directing her troops in front of her, you know, indicating where she wants them to close that ball, setting it up, making Lanice look open, and then, you know, daring that feeder to pass the ball, and there she was ready to pounce on that intercept. Great work from Francis.
South Africa 22, England 24, heading into the last minute of this second quarter. Gone quickly enough.
Oh, that's Coach Lana Kricha of the Baby Spa Proteas. See, she's sitting as if she's sitting on the hot bench, the way she's stressing.
Say Baby Spa Proteas, looked like she was giving birth then, the pressure on her face.
So that's the woman that coached me and taught me everything I know.
A hero.
Contact wing defense.
Seeing the work she's doing there, we saw the Baby Spa Proteas play before this. And just look immense. 22-26, just the lead then for England. The last few seconds of this quarter.
England! Vantage break, wing attack, Vantage instruction.
Another goal back then for South Africa, 23 up for them, just narrowing that gap. And this from Kadeen Corbin, just to take that gloss off that for it. Will be South Africa with the centre pass. They'll need to be quick the last few seconds of this quarter. England extending their lead in it. South Africa came back at them strong after that first quarter lead by England. But England now really closing the pressure out through the last few minutes of this one. Msomi and Stoltz has had to come out quite a lot in this quarter to try and get some more. And talking about coming out, there's Fran Williams just forcing her way through the traffic and coming away with the ball for England. They'll end this quarter with ball in hand. Looking around the circle edge from Clark. And Haythornthwaite combining again. Bounce out to Corbin. We've seen a lot of movement from both attacking ends in this quarter.
Yeah, and so much England, you know, running down the clock. Want to make sure that when they convert this ball, maybe that whistle will blow. It is their centre pass, so they've got 7 seconds, 6 seconds to get a goal.
Need to be quick in the transition. The long one in and into the hands of South Africa. The crowd sensing perhaps that South Africa can do something with it, but the clock beats them. And certainly England in that quarter, Zanella, just seemed to have a little bit too much. The change was made by South Africa, but it's England that go into the half with the advantage. South Africa 23, England 28.
Exciting times for netball. This is the start of a three-match series. South Africa, England, both sides under new coaches. We're seeing fresh faces out on the court. At the moment, England have the edge by 5 goals. The halftime score is 28-23. That shooting partnership of Cardwell and Corbin working well. A sellout crowd at the Cape Town Velodrome. Expect some changes, no doubt, over the next 30 minutes. Here with Pam in the studio. And Pam, what have you seen from the Roses over the last 30 minutes?
I thought it's been a really confident performance in terms of they've weathered the storm, they've got the lead, and as I said, after the first quarter, South Africa came back. But in this second quarter, they've really pushed on. And it's been the work of all the players, the feeding from that midcourt from Jade Clark, Nat Hay-Thornthwaite into the circle to holding and moving shooters has been on song, and I'm loving the Fran-Stacey combination in the back.
OK, who do you want to talk about first?
So, I wanted to talk a little bit about the through court from an England
attack.
Which
is working really nicely.
Really,
and Nat
well.
Hay-Thornthwaite as captain, you're pretty happy with her so far?
I am, yeah. She's really stepped up to the mark. And I'm going to start with a not-so-great one and then show you when it works really well.
Okay.
So, because there have been times, hence South Africa have come back into the game, is when England haven't been.
We expected that. It was never going to be perfect because this is a new look side. We've got a mixture of youth and experience in this squad.
Exactly. So if we start to play this through, so this is off the centre pass. Jay takes the ball. England are patient. They swing it back to Nat Panigari on the back, but then they have to go back for the ball. If I pause it there, this is where I'd like to see them still attack. So Nat is coming round down the back. If Jay could just wait a fraction longer, it will free up and then you've got two players in the likes of Cardwell and Kadeen ready to take on under the post.
Okay.
However, the ball goes back to the line and England then have to replay again. Cardwell comes up, which is great. So it swings here, hold here. So Kadeen to Corbin, as you can see, just taking the ball here. As a shooter, you want them to be confident going to the post. So I would love to see her just turn and either shoot the ball,
yeah,
as a shooter, is what you do, or...
This is your position, Pam. This is
my position.
See.
But by turning, it means these two have to come off her, have to give her 3 feet, which gives her a little bit of space. But by going straight back to the line, as we see the turnover, so Randa Merva gets to come onto that ball. Mm. So it's all about positivity going towards the post. So if we show you the second one, this is where they do it really well.
Okay.
So as the ball's coming down, so similar setup coming through the court in terms of using the backup play to take the ball down. Fran Williams helps out. This time, Kadeen, as we see, came up the middle. And then she then was able to do this lateral ball. You know, I said about the last time where I would have liked to see Nat Hay-Thornthwaite go down,
yes,
the right?
I was listening,
you
Pam.
You were listening? Yeah. This time she's gone down the left and this ball is able to go and bang straight into Ellie Cardwell under the post.
Perfect. And she's providing, she's starting to be really creative and,
yeah,
providing a lot of space, isn't she, Ellie?
Really good.
Impressed with her so far.
Really impressed because, in like that example, how she held that front position. She didn't let the defenders come round her, so as soon as the ball landed on the edge of the circle, she was ready for it.
Yeah, such a great player. We can't forget coming on in the final few minutes of the Super League final and really helping Manchester Thunder clinch that title, a vital player. Okay. In terms of England's defence, we've got Stacey Francis and Fran Williams, and you were pretty happy with,
yeah,
them starting. What have you seen from both of those players?
Really good in terms of how their switch of play. So they've not been afraid to stay on their goal shooter or their goal attack. They're switching to play together. And I've got one clip to show you just how successful that can be.
This is working well,
really,
isn't it?
Really well.
Yeah. This is the first time we've been using this touchscreen in the studio. And so far, Pam, you're doing amazingly.
Oh, thanks, Pam. Thanks. So if I show you England defence now.
Yeah.
South Africa centre pass. We get the ball here. I've stopped it there. Bongi's got it on top of skirt. You see Fran out in the corner. She's on Renske Stoltz. If I play it a little bit further forward, we now see Stacey come into the position and she's on Lenise Potgieter. They're both sitting behind their player.
Yeah.
As you can see, they've got the inside, pushing them up the court. As the ball plays, it swings round and then we pause it here. We see the switch. So before, Stacey was on Potgieter, Fran was on Renske Stoltz. But now you've got Stacey on Stoltz and Fran on Potgieter. This means the hassle that Francis is doing here puts doubt into Misomi's mind.
Yes.
So she plays this high ball, misses off, and
which
Fran's
is always
able
a bit of a risky one, isn't it, the high ball?
Really
going into
risky, but why it was so successful is because Fran stepped up so hard.
Yeah.
it meant that, sorry, Stacey stepped up so hard, it meant that Fran had all the backspace to cover.
Yeah, it's a really nice combination happening there. Do you expect to see any changes from Jess going into this third quarter?
I would hope so. They've got a nice cushion there with that 5 lead. I thought it was really important that they started strong and they started well to build that confidence. But now is the chance to put some players out there to give them a chance. Don't just pepper everyone onto the squad. Don't make wholesale changes, but bring some of that youth in to play around the experience.
It's a great opportunity there, but would she want to change players when they're winning, you know, 28-23 at the moment?
Well, it's what this tour is about. Yes, England want to win, and they are going to win. Whoever they put out on the court, I'm sure Jess's first thought in her mind is, we want this win for this first game.
Yeah.
But her also thought is that, I'm developing a group of players. We want to give them international experience. So put them on there, give them a chance, and see what they can do.
South Africa, what will their head coach be saying to them right now? They're behind, they're on home soil, they want to win these three games.
Yes, definitely. And it's about that fight, that spirit. You've got Lenice doing a good job in that back, hassled by Stacey and Fran. I think Renze Stotts, maybe that goal attack position, just needs a little bit of a change to give a little bit more influence into that.
But she's a great player. I mean, we've seen her in this country playing fast fives, and she's been brilliant.
My God, she can shoot from anywhere in the circle, but she's missed a couple. She just needs to get more into it.
OK, well, England leading by 5 goals, but as we know in sports, anything can happen. He's happy, isn't he? And so are we. More Netball coming up in a couple of minutes. It is South Africa against England being played in Cape Town. The first of 3 matches live on Sky Sports with tomorrow at 12:30 and on Sunday slightly earlier time of 10:30. The scoreline for this first game at the moment, England have the edge by 5 goals. 28-23, the fans are loving it. It is a sellout in the Velodrome. And youngsters from all over the place have come to watch this game. And some new faces in both sides, both head coaches trying out players in some different positions. There's Nat Haythornthwaite, the captain of the England Roses. So far, so good. Has Jess made any changes? Let's find out from our commentary team out in South Africa.
The coach make a change in the goal attack position, and she has Lefebvre Radaman has come on and goal attack for the Spa Proteas.
So a big moment for Radaman.
Very big moment. One of the players in our varsity netball competition. She was the varsity netball player of the year. Very brilliant, playing for the University of Free State. New cap, very young, but nerves are steel, and she's not afraid to take those shots. She's confident. You'd swear she's been in the spa protest side for a couple of years.
And yet only just made her debut here at the Africa Cup.
South Africa!
So another real talent in that attacking third for South Africa. South Africa with the ball. Joanne with the one of the other changes in that. Oh, and the space, she was calling for it. The movement already, the quick feet around that circle.
Yeah, and she's brilliant. You know, she's so creative in the shooting circle. She sets up one of the most strongest screens. And I think she gives the niece a little bit of confidence because she knows that she's also going to share the responsibility in that circle.
England, though, good defensive work. I'd say they come away with it, but South Africa, too, come out energized. Thorea, who's been impressive at that center bib on her back. Good splits.
Yeah, so that center position is open. I mean, Erin Burger, you know, has, you know, announced her retirement. So Romaine really grabbing that with two hands. So does Shadeen Vandermeer.
Well, we heard that call of Vandermeer a couple of times in that first half. Just her ability to turn that ball over and again proving priceless for South Africa. Their centre pass to and back to three goals.
Yeah, this is a crazy start in this third quarter from the Spa Proteas. The fresh legs doing a good job.
Podgita. Oh, her eyes in. Her eyes in. We saw that the first two quarters they were shooting around about 85%. And already just proving those goals through and back to just two goals. Malcolm, you on at that position. Cardwell does well to make sure that that one ends up in England hands. I mean, it looked good, but it was also read by Mwene about 4 hours earlier, wasn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. I think really the combination of Shadeen and Mwene is becoming, it's coming together nicely. This is one of the things that the coach of the Spa Proteas, the Red Barnhorse, was worried about, because we know that Phumza Mawene has been in combination for many years with Carla Pretorius.
Not sure they can believe at the moment just how well these two
that
combinations are working.
Contact way.
Cardwell from distance.
Contact shooter.
And the contact called against Mawene. Mawene is a Hollywood story waiting to be made, isn't it? The mother who, was it when she was 29, just really took up senior level netball. Her 10-year-old son, she was telling me, she's expecting to see him in the crowd today. He'll be wearing one of her T-shirts.
Oh, that's absolutely beautiful. Very humble, Phumza Mawene leads by example.
I mean, there are hot feet, and then there are hot feet. Just seeing that 1-2 step across, making everything happen. Hello, international netball.
Yep, hello, Lefebvre Rudderman. You know, just putting on that verb and just making sure she makes the most of this moment. Exactly what the Spa Proteas needed. It's a gun attack who's fearless,
that is contact wing attack.
Confident, and accurate.
That is contact wing defense.
South Africa were five goals down heading into this quarter, and now they're back level. Big passage of play for England. Haythornthwaite into that goal attack to body back into those South Africa defenders, draws them out, and Cardwell, beautiful shot through.
There's a lot being said there by Cardwell, just charging up her troops.
Vandermeer to Thorea. So impressive. Work around that circle.
Oh no, this is good play from the Spa Proteas.
Those changes working.
And that's what's important, to know which player to bring on and give clear instructions as to what you expect from them when they step onto that court.
Oh, contact call.
Yes. Goal defense, back where it was. Thank you.
Williams won't mind just having to go back a little bit longer. It eats into that clock.
Contact wing defense. Wing defense, come forward. Thank you.
Overeager from... So Casey's her nickname. I keep hearing everyone telling me how Casey is going to be brilliant. She's going to be for South Africa for the next 5-10 years.
I agree with them wholeheartedly, especially now that she's going to be going to play in England. She's going to gain the experience there. She can bring all of that back to South Africa.
Tanisa Chawane up the other end of the court. Wing defence, Bibon, now puts in that defensive work for England.
Contact wing defence.
And I talked her into that contact.
Step forward where it was.
Yeah, well, as a wing defence, I mean, I used to be a wing defence. That's your job. You've got to work that wing attack. You've got to try and smother them. Take them out of the game, you know. So if you don't get any calls against you as a wing defence, then you're not doing your job.
Particularly with Laura Malcolm fresh on court.
Advantage goal, South Africa.
You can see how hot they're finding it on court, but our side's still playing with that smile.
Oh, it's great vision from Chawane.
It's almost like slow motion up to the point that it gets into Radebe's hands.
Hold
and
it,
she's
keep
just
it, take a seat, take
all
a
of
break.
A sudden injected Better. That energy in. Maybe that Stoles didn't have, but the ability
keep
as well to
off,
to put the shot take. Up.
Back with her.
Oh, she misses that one. Does Lefebvre and I'm unfortunate to be getting that ball against South Africa.
Found your side. Contact keeper.
Certainly giving that defensive circle for England much more to think about. Stacey Francis, the goalkeeper Vivon, and Williams in there too.
Stretching hands before both. England!
So Nella, you're happy with these combinations at the moment? Would you hope that the coach kind of sticks with these to the end of the game? You've got to try and let teams play through it, haven't you?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think they're doing well at the moment. Seeing Mbonyi is not on court. Maybe something different in the last quarter. Bring in Mbonyi Msomi on the center position to replace Romay Dreya. That's a good rebound from Phumza Maweni.
It's Captain Haythornthwaite who put the shot up. And it's South Africa that have it. Bantha Merva. Oh, there's a ball. There's a pass, and she combined with a post at the end. Pogita back on her feet. This one needs Radama to finish it off. She's all right. She's looking up at the net. She's full contact with the post. No umpire whistle for that. The post will take it. Radama will take it, and that was a beautiful ball. Everything behind that.
Absolutely. This is good play.
Knowing Lee Pogita, that post will have come off worse there.
Yep, that's a good call from the umpire. She came in there, she did bump Williams.
South Africa with the goal lead then. Just over 6 minutes of this third quarter. England being forced into using full court.
This is good defense from the Spa Proteas.
Now the chance of defense go up as well.
Good patience though being exercised by England around that circle's edge, not forcing that ball to a shooter that is sandwiched between two defenders. Really being patient, making sure that it lands in Cardwell's hands. And she makes no mistake and converts.
Yeah, Ellie Cardwell been shooting at 85%. Nat Haythornthwaite in that change at a goal attack.
South Africa.
She might not be getting the goals at the moment, that Haythornthwaite, but she gives an option inside that circle to move things around. Here comes South Africa.
That is contact, not five.
Yeah, Lefebvre Radaman. Fearless. That's the name that I use to describe her. Dynamite comes in small packages, and this girl has got nerves of steel. You throw in the deep end, she will not sink, she'll swim.
35 all. Cardwell to nudge England further ahead. Well, you won't tell me about umpire decisions, but you might tell me which way you think this one was going. It's so tight.
Yeah, this one's definitely obviously going right down to the wire. Phew, yeah, it's going to be, yeah, it's really that the last quarter for me in the last few minutes of the last quarter. Can they maintain this intensity and this momentum and the discipline, especially when they turn ball, are they able to capitalize? And what's improved as well for me in this quarter is, yeah, that's exactly what I was going to say. It's that defense from the Spa Proteas. Because I asked, I put a question to them. I said, what kind of defensive pattern are you putting up? You know, we're not quite sure. It's not clear enough. Now we're seeing it. Everybody manning their own player, making sure that they're putting so much pressure there on the Roses.
And then when you do that, you give them something else to think about and the mind goes out the window. Now what can South Africa do? England one way, South Africa the other, and Stacey France is sensing it, went for the fly through, but Riderman was in there, the ball found her. Oh, good defensive recovery by England though.
Apparently the shooters say that those are the worst balls to try and convert, the ones right under the pole. They can take the shot from far, but close by, the chances of missing are quite high. Great conversion from Porchitter.
That passage of play, that minute, was pretty much how we've seen this whole match so far. Just moments of brilliance and just trying to unlock both defenses. Hustle in the circle from England. South Africa. I counted three in that. You know, maths isn't my strong point, but that was hell.
Yeah, I think a little bit of doubt and hesitation there from Chrisel. She could have still given it to Runnemann, even a bounce pass. Just make sure you keep ball in hand.
Bristol in that wing attack position. Looks on as England now attacking. Malcolm, who's come on court in this quarter. Panagari back on at wing defence for England.
Stand up. Where you are? Pausing, goalkeeper. Yes.
Oh, don't ever leave the circle's edge. That's the golden rule. Romay Dre not there to pick up that ball. She was already walking to the centre circle.
England centre.
And South Africa had another chance then. That was an opportunity. England shut the door. But that was more South Africa's doing. Centre pass, England. Just over 2 minutes of this third quarter. 37 all. Clark lands it, great weight on that little ball in to Cardwell.
South Africa!
The experience normally that England have in that attacking end with Housby and Hart, and Cardwell's done well. South Africa again. They're being forced into some of these spectacular passes, but at the moment they're coming off.
That is contact!
Oh, Raraman again. Such poise from her, too. This crowd that they've experienced that with the Africa Cup with her as well. But she's willing to take that expectation that she's got on her shoulders.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, since Marega Holthausen retired, and she was playing goal attack for the Spa Proteas all the years, and that's a young player in Raraman. Big shoes to fill, but she's filling them.
Take all tech advantage offside.
Last minute then of this third quarter. 15 to go after this. Two more games to come in this series. But this very much both these new coaches wanting to lay down the marker. At the moment, South Africa have had those questions to answer by England. They were down at half time. They've made those two decisive changes, and in that circle, they've given England much more to think about.
Yeah, I must say, this is the calmest I've seen the coach of the Spa Proteas, Dorit Badenhorst.
Just holding time again.
South Africa's
been just
a pass.
Some sweat on the court being mopped up to our left. And that's where we
just
saw Choen van der Merwe putting their bodies on the line and flying through just to try and win that ball back off England. One goal in it. Centre pass to South Africa. Some vital seconds on the clock. And Sanella, the advantage to go in ahead into that final quarter, what would it do for the South Africa side?
Definitely, it will actually indicate to them that they had a really good quarter and that they are ahead, and all that's important is for them to just really have a clinical last 15 minutes. Leading by two are the Spa Proteas.
Last few seconds then, England two behind. They won't draw it level, but they'll try and get that goal back. Time held. Will they have the ball?
Outside the circle, it's contact. Yes.
The England's pass on the edge of the circle. Jay Clark, their most capped player, with it. To Haythornthwaite, the captain, and through the net. That was a big goal. Won't be enough to draw them level as the Hooter goes. They were 12-15 down, South Africa, after the first quarter. They were 23-28 down after the second quarter. But they head in to the final 15 minutes, and they're ahead. South Africa with the lead over England in this first test, 40-39.
South Africa have taken the lead after three quarters. It's 40-39. What a turnaround in those last 15 minutes. It was 17-11 to South Africa. They showed a lot of flair, dynamism, created a lot of space. Pam Cookie's with me. And Pam, what did you see? What did they do so well?
Two players for me, Van der Merwe at wing at goal defence and the Rudderman coming on at goal attack. Phenomenal, opening up the space and being able to, that attacking and just creating the space, giving those passes off to Potgieter and her composure. She's new. Like, we've
tell us a little bit about this new goal attack, Rudderman. What's her pedigree? Where's she from?
So, player of the year at the Varsity 2019. We've never seen her on an international scene before, but on here, on this court, she's playing with such fearlessness. She's attacking the post. She's very rarely missed, if I've seen that at all. But also her through court play has been on song. She's quick. She gets the ball, she turns, she offloads, she's gone again. And that's really helped that attacking end for South Africa. And it's making Fran Williams and Stacey Francis have to really think about what they're doing.
Well, if it's a player that they've never seen and never played against, it's very difficult to control that player. So they'll be thinking, oh, we need a change of tactic going into this fourth quarter. What will Jess be saying to them?
Well, definitely, yeah. And as you say, if you've not seen someone before, you can't have done your analysis beforehand. Yeah. But you've played against goal attacks of different stature, whether they're holding, whether they're moving, whether they're stronger, whether they're long passes, whether they're feeders, or whether they want to go to post. So the defenders would have played against different goal attacks. So now, after seeing what she does in that last quarter, need to make a change straight up now.
OK, let's talk about Laura Malcolm, wing attack. Wrong position, isn't it?
Well, we normally see her at wing defence or centre as well. She's had a little dabble at wing attack, but it's just not seeming to happen for them in the attacking end.
OK, fourth quarter, right now.
Giving ball away to the Roses. 50 minutes, everything to play for. They would want to bank a win here, South Africa, because then that will put all the pressure on the Roses to try and win the next match, which is tomorrow.
They started the year with a win against England. They lost in that vital bronze medal match. Now England are up against it on South African soil. Bongi Mosomi, the South Africa captain, said this was what was important about beating England on their home soil and about proving a point under their new coach. Two goals to the good at the moment.
Yeah, so no changes from the South African side. That's great contesting from Kanyisa Chawana. Two changes from the English Roses in this last quarter.
Yeah, positional change too. We've seen Jay Clark, England's most capped player, move to wing defence. Nat Panagari moving into that central position, vice captain for this team. And it's defensive work going to be needed again from England. And de Merwe stood out really for this South Africa side in those first three quarters. Consistent, has made things happen. So any one of the young players coming through, and there's another. Radoman, who's come on such an impact at that goal attack position, and Poggita like a fine wine.
Yes, I must say, Radoman has been the change that South Africa needed in that shooting circle and on the attack. Fresh legs, it's got energy for days, and she's really made it very difficult for the England defenders, giving them something to think about, constantly making them reposition. So that was a good move from Coach Dorette Badenhorst.
Good defensive work though from England. Stacey Francis pushing that 3 seconds to the edge.
Contact, advantage offside, wing attack.
Malcolm has a little dance around, and Panagari, good movement from the captain. Hayton Quake then finishing off the move. You'll know, Zanella, from playing this highest level netball with South Africa, just again how quickly things shift around. Seeing those last goals, that run that South Africa put on, all important, those last couple of goals for England. What will that do to South Africa?
Yeah, you see, that's the thing. And this is what happened to South Africa, to England in that third quarter. We were scoring continuous goals, and it's sort of, you know, the momentum of England went down. But South Africa's important for them not to allow England to gain the confidence and sort of put their foot on the accelerator. Stay focused.
Sorry, I was just looking at the visual reminder of the last time South Africa beat England.
In netball or rugby?
That was in rugby. Been there, done that, and she got the t-shirt. Right, now here come England, landed by Malcolm. I mean, that was just cruel, really.
You still got two more games.
Back to a goal. So this is now going to come down to who can be consistent. That won't help.
Yeah, that's a good take from Malcolm. Bringing that ball down for England.
Managed contact shooter.
Consistent and clinical is the name of the game in this last quarter.
Going. Wiwa. No goal tech. Move out. Further out. Wiwa.
Sorting out positions inside that circle.
Contact in, do your holding.
Oh, good movement too. Such was the body on body inside that circle. Rainey just under close contact. They had to try and do something to figure that out.
Burning straight goal attack.
Back level. I know you were about to shout it. It didn't come off of Vandermeer then. She's been so close time after time.
Oh, she's really playing good netball at the moment.
Look at that, ridiculous, the deflection, 6-1.
Sorry, see the spot protest setting up a zone defense here. Will it pay off?
Oh, nearly.
Top and side.
That's good work from Kanyisa Chawane. She's not even a specialist wing defense, but she plays with so much heart. Throws her body on the line.
A brilliant addition to the Netball Super League in the UK. Big loss, of course, to... And I know that, Zanella, that's one of the things to try and develop that professional league here in South Africa.
No, absolutely. If we want to compete against the best teams in the world and be the best team in the world, we need a professional league. And this is what we've been preaching. And we know people are listening. We just hope that sponsors and can come on board and really back the girls.
That is contact.
A couple of errors in there.
Contact
South Africa ahead going into this quarter, find themselves a goal behind. And this could swing back to
band offside,
to if England can capitalise. Oh, just think sometimes, isn't it?
Straight up.
Yeah, just misfed that ball to Cardwell. Wow. I'm not sure where who Pumza Mawin was passing that ball to. That's one thing they always say about goalkeepers. They're not really good passers. Just pass the short ball. Don't go for the long one.
Contact with the defense.
You've only known me a short time, but I am greedy. If this is level at the end, fancy some extra time. We're way off that yet.
Extra time for the first test match.
Not if England have something to do with it. That was an important goal. South Africa had chances in that passage too.
Yeah, and this is what I was saying, you know, they were two goals up going into this last quarter. Some silly errors.
Band offside, seems
losing hard. Crucial and critical ball.
That is contact, Zita.
Momeni actually went in and repositioned Cardwell's arms. Like South one of those Africa. Artist dummies then, didn't she? But still Cardwell wrestled her off.
Yeah, so South Africa don't want to give England this lead. Don't want it to widen. Stay in it, because if England pull away, it's going to be very hard to close that gap.
England!
Not a big goal. Would you leave this seven on?
Go on.
If you're a threat, they're still getting those moments, aren't they?
Yeah. I would maybe make one change and bring William Somi on the center position.
Where you are, goal take.
We've seen Msomi actually expelling a lot of energy on the sideline. She's been bouncing up and down trying to cheer her side on.
Throw in wing area. Yes.
Malcolm into Panagari with that center bibble.
Contact on defense. Back one.
It was almost a mirror image of you at the moment. That.
Yes.
Pondering everything in the crowd. Which way will it go? At the moment, it's England who've just got the advantage back. 47-44. Sarah Simpson looking on from the sidelines. Again, one of those that's been instrumental, flown in over the last day or so, to be here with this England team and seeing the changes for them, the structure around. But South Africa aren't letting them get ahead. 6:30, plenty of time left to level and take this one for South Africa.
Yeah, England changing it up now on the centre pass, playing to the back players. We saw a lot in the first half of the game that the centre pass was going to the front players more often than not. Oh, Pumza Maweni! Take a bow! We've been waiting for, you see, I did say she's going to come up for those balls and she will get at least one of them, and that's a crucial one that she just got for the SPA Proteas.
All well and good getting the ball, you got to deliver the end product, and South Africa have done that, back to within one and the ball in hand. Can they draw it back level?
That is not the side, that is contact wing defence, contact goal defence, hand on ball, that's it.
Tension in the crowd, tension on court.
Tension in the commentary booth.
No. Been here, seen this before, both these sides. In the semi-finals, both of them so narrowly defeated at the World Cup. Then that bronze medal match, going head-to-head, toe-to-toe with one another. England coming out with that win. But now, in Cape Town, South Africa, desperate to put a match on. And there's Van der Merwe. She takes the ball, she passes the ball, and they come away with it again. Dreja into Poggita, feeds out to Grizel on the edge of the circle, and there's the calmness. Radaman, like she's been playing international netball for the last decade. They're ahead, 5 minutes to go, South Africa with the advantage. They've wrestled it back from England. Now how did this England team react? Chaweni.
That was absolutely brilliant. Brilliant from Shadeen van der Merwe. That's exactly where Pumza Maweni took the previous intercept into that pocket. They're reading it well. We did say it's going to go right down to the wire this game.
That is
Two goals up. Two up. Now come the sounds from inside the velodrome in Cape Town.
That is Conte with the
defense. The chance of defense, defense again from the South African crowd. They've seen their team on this court win the Africa Cup. They've seen a new coach come in. Old legends of the game retire. And the young blood coming through. And at the moment, beating England. Oh, that was close.
Yeah, this is good defensive work from the Spa Proteas.
Maweni and Vandermeer know these England girls. They've played in the Super League. They know their strength, they know the weaknesses, and they know to rattle them at the moment. But it's a goal back. 3.5 minutes. What defensive work can England put on?
Contact centre at the edge.
Contact call against Panagari.
So we always say the most important thing is keep your own centre passes. It's easier said than done, but then Linnie Sportfitter makes no mistake, converts that goal for the Spa Proteas. You can see how elated the crowd is.
Clark Kent is now happy. Superman's arrived in the building. Jay Clark over the top into Haythornthwaite. Still got plenty of time. The England bench up. Summer Hartman in the background trying to get the team going again. Oh, little contacts called all over. Just eats into the clock. At the moment, England still have time. Another close one. Cardwell. Back to a goal. And now it just shifts again up the other end. Can England force that ball back? Laura Malcolm gets it. England have it. Haythornthwaite lands it. Now they need that calmness that evaded them a few moments ago. Panagari and Malcolm. Who made that move work? Just too close from Zaire. Just too close. This, Ellie Cardwell for England to level it up. 50-50. And that's the chances at the moment for both these sides too. Sweat on the court. I don't know if it's just, everyone needs a breather. Oh, how calm do you need to be? You have been in these situations before, Zanella, and it's not about luck, is it? It's about heart, desire, and just playing right to the end.
No, absolutely, and South Africa now must defend like beast, try and turn this ball, convert it, and then it will be their centre pass, and try and run the clock down and use that centre pass. And this is what they're trying to do now, delaying the English side. You were calling that it might go to extra time. Caroline, there's an opportunity for South Africa.
I was just about to ask you for your player of the match, but give it a moment. It could still swing. England had a chance. Now South Africa have it. But this will take like an age to get up through court. There's the defensive work again from England.
Yep, they're
heading in South Africa.
Yeah, urgency from England. You can see the clock is ticking. South Africa need to score. Oh my goodness, she couldn't contain that ball.
Oh, a minute and 20. And now back to England. Can't take your eyes off it. This is just the first of three tests. Every one of these, please let it be like this. Oh, splits from Cardwell. She has been calm all through this game. And she nudges England in front. Still time for South Africa. Will we go to extra time? If we're all level, we will. Hold off on that player of the match.
Center third, South Africa. Hold time. Do we need to
time called.
That's okay.
I'm just asking whether they need to mop up the court. I don't think anyone wants anything to stop right now, do they?
Just here.
Particularly your heart, I think, Zanella. How's the beat going?
Goodness gracious me, my heart. This is exciting, but this is good quality netball.
What a
test
for these players. What a first test for that bench, for those coaches. And now, who wants to stand up? The last 30 seconds. Do they count down the clock? That's dangerous. They've been there before. England will know they have advantage. They won't mind this. If they take their time, all they need to do is get to circle and shoot that goal. Simple, hey? Got to get it there first. Malcolm.
That is contact.
Haythornthwaite, the captain, came out for it. still taking their time around. Risky business. Can they get it into the circle? Here comes the defensive pressure again from South Africa. The clock's on their side. It's not on England. Cardwell turns. She has the time. She doesn't have the measure. South Africa have it. They'll go quick through court. But no, we will go to extra time. I told you, Zanella, don't give me your player of the match, because we've got more time to take with this.
My goodness, Cardwell with that ball in hand. She could have converted it and England would have won this game by one goal. But this is the quality and the standard of both these teams.
Oh, the South Africa netball president stands to attention to applaud her players. Both these teams have given us full throttle netball. 51-all at full time. Guess what? You'll enjoy it. We've got extra time to come.
Well, we wanted some excitement post the World Cup. My goodness, we've got it, Pamela Cookie. 50 goals each. It looked like it was going to go England's way at the end. Ellie Cardwell, she just couldn't get that final goal, but they were playing the ball around the circle, going backwards. We were screaming, go for it, get it in the circle. What was happening there?
Indeed, I think the pressure maybe of the situation getting to them, but as you say, they just needed to get that ball down the court, into the circle, give themselves a little bit more time, and then that last shot from Ellie was under pressure and just missing it there. But wow, what a game this has turned out to be.
Nat Haythornthwaite just having a chat with the new head coach of the England Roses, Jess Thirlby. She's a tactician, isn't she? She's a technical coach. We've seen her at Team Bath. She's been part of the England under 21 setup. What will she be saying to them right now? It's 7 minutes each way in extra time.
Yeah, indeed. And it'll be about, as you said, Jess is very technical coach. She's really good at how she can kind of develop players and get the best out of themselves. Now, in this 7 minutes, it's about how the team can come together and gel and just play smart netball. You don't want to, these lovely passes that we're seeing from South Africa, that's how they clawed themselves back into this game. Their defensive pressure, so, so good, with Pumza Mweni and Van der Merwe, made it really difficult for England throughout, and their attack were able to capitalise on that. So for England, it's about playing with no fear. How they started this game, sensible, but giving that ball. Don't get hesitant, and that allows the South African defence to come through.
Yeah, we're looking at the both shooting circles. Ellie Cardwell there, who's played for the full 60 minutes. To clarify, they've got 51-51. That was a great zooming ball in, a bit of a stinger there from Laura Malcolm, who is being bedded in as a wing attack in this game. But let's have a look at the shooting circle for South Africa. There's Raderman with Pokita, and Raderman's come on. She came on in the third quarter and has been a bit of a game changer.
Oh, definitely. She has been on song. Her shot, as we saw in that last clip, straight through the net. Her partnership with Pokita. She's being a feeder, but she's also being a playmaker and going to the post. So lovely footwork, lovely hands. And she's been playing with fearlessness. Like, she has just come onto this court and taken this game. First time, as we said, seeing her on the international stage.
You know, some of the stats from the game, and what figures ping out at you, Pam, is you've just been thrown out.
No, and so attempts at goal, 64 for England, 58 for South Africa. So that's showing in the shooting stats, with 80 for England and 88 for South Africa. They've had the opportunities, England, to be ahead in this game, but not necessarily taken them. In terms of turnovers, 23 for South Africa, 17 for England. They've been a bit wasteful with the ball, bringing it through the court. Their shooters have been on song, but coming through the court is where they've been their downfall.
Yeah, she's been trying out, Jess has been trying out different combinations, hasn't she? We saw a change in that centre position. Jay Clark going to wing defence and Nat Panigari coming in that centre position, which we've seen her, of course, at Loughborough Lightning doing so well at. There's Raderman, who was speaking about the goal attack for South Africa. So 7 minutes each way. Caroline Barker's out there with the commentary team. Let's get straight back out there.
Everyone wants this one to end. We'll have a winner at the end of it if it comes from extra time. Or a couple of clear goals after that. We'll be done in extra time, won't we, Zanella?
Definitely got to be done in extra time. My heart can't take it anymore.
So you might be done. South Africa with it. They could have lost the game in those dying seconds. Now they have a chance to go back. Pogita. Is there any other answer when that's the question. Pogita puts up a shot, you know it's going to.
Yeah, absolutely. Just give her the ball, she'll do the rest without fail. Very consistent is Pogita, but so is Cardwell.
South Africa
doing the same for England.
Goal for goal. Panagari, that centre Bibom. You wonder whether we'd see Bongi and Somi, we haven't. Would you see any changes for England, Zanella?
Oh, we see is Jade Clark. Yeah, okay, Clark's still on court. I'd love to see what Kadeen Corbin would do in the goal attack position, and maybe move the captain to wing attack, replacing Malcolm.
And there is a goal attack captain Nat Haythornthwaite. Laura Malcolm with one of those changes, that wing attack bid. Panagari the centre on her back. Drea doing a dance in front of her, trying to put her off. The Merva had a little go. And Cardwell again.
South Africa.
Looks like she's put behind her that final shot. Oh, Stacey Francis. Well, back after 2 years out.
She's been quiet, but she's now saying, don't forget about me, I'm here. That's a brilliant take out of that circle from Francis.
Real quality moment for England. That's what Stacey Francis gives you. Panagari just gets it over. I mean, that's not easy to get over and win it. Oh, and that goes.
That was close too from Cardwell.
We're on a 7 minutes. Wait for extra time. The 2 7-minute halves. And England with the early, and I mean early, advantage. They won the first two quarters. South Africa won the second. We were tied up at 51-all. South Africa have come back. And England have come back. One blow, then another blow. No one with a knockout yet.
Yeah, overcooked it. Haythornthwaite. Overcooked that ball to Cardwell. They've got to exercise patience. They can't feed the balls from that distance.
Now South Africa need to echo that and be patient themselves. Van der Merwe. Oh, that was an angry take. She wasn't letting that one go.
Position, no, position, Peter. Position.
And that was possession. So surely have that.
Stratton. South Africa. Burning striking attack.
And that's how quickly it changes. Now South Africa with their centre pass.
Yeah, we're looking at the goal percentages. 89 for South Africa and 81 for England. Brilliant still in
that
the 80s.
That's not going to help.
That's very uncharacteristic. Never seen Lenise Borghita overshoot a ball like that.
All those shots that have gone in from here, there and everywhere. And that one's still being gathered up somewhere down by the harbour, I think. Francis with it.
That is contact wing advantage obstruction.
This is as much about England being patient. Cardwell had a little look. Just too far out, resets herself. That was good work. Does she fancy it from here? So difficult to tell, and they've got to be completely on it every second.
Yep, unfortunately chose to be a shooter. The responsibility is on you to convert the goals for your team. Oh, that's a better feed from Malcolm.
South Africa.
Still plenty of time in this half for South Africa. A reminder, it was tied at 51-all at the end of full time, hence why we're in extra time. This is the first of three, and everyone going to be like this, we hope. South Africa back within a goal.
So the question I have, is there a player you can bring on that can replace Williams on the goal defence position?
It's whether you bring Kwashim perhaps into that goalkeeper. Do you move maybe Francis out into that? You feel that maybe that's where they need to make a change at the moment?
Yeah, I think that would be, that could be a possibility and an option that could work for England.
Williams, Super League winner, is at that World Cup with England too. At the moment it's up the other end, England where maybe in the tightest of margins needed to improve. Here comes the captain, and that was the captain's goal.
Yeah, she didn't even hesitate, she just faced the pole, did what she's been doing well tonight when she's been playing goal attack.
Zanella, have you faced extra time? What's going through the legs, what's going through the head? Not right now, because I know you're feeling it.
Fortunately, I've never faced extra time, so I cannot imagine what these players are going through, but they've got to stay in it, they've got to stay tuned in, stay focused.
Last 30 seconds of this first 7 minutes of extra time. England with ball in hand. Malcolm could work again, just forcing England around court, South Africa. Malcolm being forced back into the same position she was. Cardwell's had to come out for it. Just playing on the edge of everything. There was a nudge in there from Van der Merwe. Put Haythornthwaite off her stride.
Where you are,
I mean, there's some close dancing going on in that circle at the moment. That one won't count, but England do have the narrowest of advantages heading into that final 7 minutes. They have the slight lead up to the tide at 51 all going in. They now have that goal advantage going into this final 7 minutes. And you can see the players, Anela, really taking it upon themselves to try and talk and work their way through this.
Yeah, absolutely. They're huddling there, talking to each other, just making sure that everybody's buying into what needs to happen for the next 7 minutes. England leading 57 to 56.
So England, the urgency to get back onto court. South Africa now joining them. We'll see the change. That centre bib, the South Africa captain, Bongi Mtsomi, is on court for this final 7 minutes.
Thank you.
The calmest face in Cape Town has the ball in hand. South Africa
contact
captain,
centre.
Mtsomi.
Yes.
Her side a goal behind. Last 7 minutes.
That's a good move. I called it. I said they need her in there. She's an engine. She's a machine. She's so fit. She can be so key for the South African side in the last 7 minutes of this game.
Oh, and she knows this England team. Nat Haythornthwaite is her teammate at Wasps, where she learned to ride a bike, to swim, to be part of that family in the UK. She is desperate, Bongi Mtsomi, for her South African family to prove a point against England. But it's England with ball in hand. Lovely ball over to Cardwell. They've already turned, they've gone up court. They have that belief in Ellie Cardwell.
Yeah, I think Cardwell's really been outstanding in that shooting circle for England. Showing up, answering all the questions that
Well, you were asking about Fran Williams. That was one of your questions in that last 7 minutes, and she's plucked that ball off the head of Bongi Mtsomi.
Yeah, well, she says, if you were a little bit concerned about me, don't be. I'm here. I'm going to finish this game. Not going anywhere. Well done to Williams. Clean take.
This could be a crucial goal to the gap. Jess Thirlby, Kat Ratnapala, the England bench. And their centre pass too. That's why that one was so key.
She's way too calm for me, Jess Thirlby. As a coach, I wouldn't be sitting so calm and composed. I'd probably be pulling my hair out. But I guess it maybe shows her belief in her players, you know, and in the systems and the work that they've put in.
5 minutes of intense sport, and the call goes the way of South Africa. Now what do they do? Chouani again impressive. Van der Merwe, the ball in. Bongi Mtsomi offering for it. And Williams again.
Hold time. No, it's a throw-in.
That was all right. It's just about the sweat on court rather than anything else.
I just want them to wipe the... just here. You see that?
And that was almost, wasn't it, a carbon copy of what had come to fall from Williams.
Yeah, absolutely. She's reading those those aerial balls very well, and coming in there very clean is Williams. So if the score is level at the end of the 7 minutes, we go to like sudden death. We call it like sudden death, where you need to be. Yeah, we need to be the whichever team is 2 goals ahead. That will be the team that will win.
And that's better rather than just the 1 goal. Given as we've seen just how tight this has been, you need that 2-goal gap. That's fair. At the moment, England have 2-goal gap in extra time. They only need the one.
Contact on the fence. That distraction seems to have thrown England.
Every call, every movement being met by the crowd. Malcolm took a legal time on that.
Flag obstruction, Wayne defeats.
England just having to play smart, and they really are pushing that 3 seconds at the moment.
Yeah, I must say, though, I love the placement of those balls from Malcolm. You know, really stretching Cardwell away from the reach of Pumza Maweni.
Throwing.
Oh! Overcooked it there to Lenis Pohitir, South Africa.
That is contact shooter.
There is still time, but 4 goals with 3.5 minutes left. If it would really put a dent in the hopes of South Africa. It's only
that
three at the moment.
Goal, find your side, centre obstruction.
Panagari, I love how players do that as well. Just when the clock's on your side, take a little bit here, umpire. This is from, not meant to be, but it's smart, isn't it?
England.
It's smart.
Yeah, this is a well-conditioned English side, I must say. Really, they're running at a very high intensity in the last few minutes of this match.
And that's where you can see the difference. The run of goals that they put on, only barely punctuated by South Africa goals. But this could be vital. There is time still, but they need to be quick in their transition. And England have been good defensively in keeping South Africa out. Francis, there's a little body check in there too.
Yes.
And it just eats down some more vital seconds.
The circle. Yes.
Now, am I going to tempt fate and ask you for a player of the match?
Contact.
Yeah, Zanella?
Okay.
Not with that goal going
South
in.
Africa.
South Africa still in this. Who stood out for you, though, from both these sides?
Yeah, I think Shadeen Fanamava really did well for me from the Spa Proteas side. So did Lefebvre Radamani.
There is Van der Merwe, contender for player of the match then. Can she pull her side back in? And that's the problem. Just when you're trying to force something, then balls go flying.
Yep, there's going to be no easy way out of this. They need to still keep ball in hand, play patiently, do what has been working, get to the circle's edge.
Malcolm, combining well with Haythornthwaite, the New England captain. Cardwell.
Sideline.
Hand on
yes,
that.
Panagari. Yes.
With the throw.
Distraction
with
center.
A minute and a half on, 3 goals in it. South Africa need to turn this one. Turn it and they give themselves a chance to draw back level. Cardwell. This
England.
Time, no mistake with that minute of pressure on. 4 goals, surely too much now, Zanella,
yep.
For South Africa.
No, definitely too much to
attack.
Ask from South Africa, especially with England centre pass with
food.
A minute left to end this game. It's been a brilliant performance from both these teams, though.
So, with less than a minute left on the
that
clock, Zanella, can you give me your player of the match then, please?
Shadeen Fanamava.
Shadeen van der Merwe not likely to get the win for South Africa as Laura Malcolm recycles the ball for England. They'll end up with ball in hand, but she'll get the player of the match. The delight is we've got 2 more games of this to come this weekend. But England, after extra time, look like they're going to pin themselves with the win. 58-63. South Africa will end up with ball in hand. Surely the clock has beaten them now as well. Bongi Mtsomi trying to find through. There's Williams again. Twice in extra time, she stood up for the Roses. Twice pulled the ball back for her side to turn that ball around and give them this vital win. 5 goals the difference. That one just too much. With the clock counting down, you can give those ones away. So now that's really just taking off the little bit of the gloss for England as the hooter goes to Jess Thirlby. her first test as coach of the England Roses. Many questions about who wasn't here with her side in this journey to Cape Town, but it's those players that she brought, that she put on court, that squad of 12, of 15, who stood up against South Africa and come away with a win. Zanella, right to the end, that was a contest, wasn't it? But just the fine margins in extra time that let South Africa down.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't think that South Africa expected to go to extra time, but at this level, you've got to be expecting those kind of things and really move up again. I think that's what the English Roses did so well in that extra time. Very clinical, did well to close this one and bank a win.
England have the win, 63-58.
So the England Roses edged away in extra time, 14 minutes. It was pretty grueling in their first game, but Victoria 63-58. And the teams congratulating each other. Don't forget that we're back tomorrow. Little smile from Renske Stoltz, who played a part for South Africa in the first 30 minutes. Nat Panagari, the captain for the Roses, will be delighted with that, as will Jess Thirlby. Confirmation of the scoreline then, winning by 5 goals. And tomorrow, 12:30 for that second match. On Sunday, the slightly earlier time on Sky Sports Mix and Arena at 10:30. So there they are. Those are the games on Arena and Mix. I'm glad I got it right. 12:30. Tomorrow we've got Tracy Neville, the former England head coach, and Ebony Osorio-Brown, who's taking a little break, a little hiatus from the England squad right now. And on Sunday, Pamela Cookie and Serena Guthrie are with me, 10:30. Pam, we were up and down in the studio. Are you relieved? Are you obviously very happy and pretty excited that England won that first game?
Yeah, we can breathe again now. Then.
just
about. Wow, what a game. And I'm really, really impressed with how the England team came out in that extra time. And they were smart, they were composed. They got some key intercepts at crucial moments, and that put the pressure on South Africa, and they weren't able to keep with them.
Who in particular stood out for you for the Roses in terms of those intercepts?
Fran and Stacey. So Fran Williams, Stacey and Francis. They were just in the right place at the right time, but read the game so well so they could come out at the right time and push that ball down the court. I thought Nat Haythornthwaite, a captain, she played the whole game. She played with composure and helped that attacking end to keep going.
Well, in terms of the defence, I know Tamsin Greenway, who's at home, was absolutely delighted with Fran Williams. She's been tweeting for the last couple of hours. Great to have her at the top of the show. But some examples of that brilliant England defence.
Yeah, and that was Stacey we just saw there coming out on that right-hand side to get the ball. And Fran, she read that from so far behind. Coming forward again, that left hand, not a dominant hand, still being able to get that intercept. And that is because they've been watching this game. We said about the third quarter how South Africa came back, the two partnerships when Redmond came on at goal attack, made the defence have to think a little bit. But they learned from that. And those two are really smart players in terms of when it came to that fourth quarter, they were that front foot again.
Yeah. We've got to remind our viewers at home that we don't have the likes of Jeeva Mentor. Who else is there? Ebony Osorio-Brown is in the studio with us tomorrow. She's not part of the setup at the moment. Joe Hart and Helen Housby, all taking a little break, a little time out. When they come back into the fold, they'll be thinking, wow, these girls have done really well, especially Stacey Francis, who's not been in the England fold for a couple of years now. She decided to take a break in 2017. Didn't feel like she was going to be the first pick. But now what have you seen? What has she shown Jess Thirlby today?
She's come up. Well, Stacey always plays with hunger, grit and tenacity. She will give 110% for 60 minutes of the game. So when she says she's going to do something, she'll put her everything into it. And so it's great that she's come into this squad and she's having that experience for that back line. So I think she's really helped Fran develop in just in this first game. We've seen how much she's lifted from that performance, but also just her own individual skill level. Mm. We saw that intercept there. We saw how she rides on the players. We saw Potgieter do an air shot. When have we hardly ever seen her do a shot?
No, that's pressure, isn't it?
That's the pressure that Stacey had built on her. So it's really strong and really great for Jess to have Stacey in that team.
OK, well, we can find out who the player of the game is. Let's find out right now.
I am joined now by the player of the match. It is Shadeen van der Merwe of the SPAR Proteas, and she's going to get her prize handed over by Claudia Mitchell from SPAR. Shadeen, just before you walk away, getting a bit excited there. Let's talk about your side's performance here today. A bit bittersweet, player of the match, but what did you make of the performance overall?
Yes, I couldn't get the player of the match if it wasn't for a whole team effort, having a good wing defense coming up and putting on that pressure. We knew we had to turn balls because they're quick on the attack, and we just need to execute on the turnovers and get goals. But I'm very proud of the team coming back, being 5 behind and actually win that quarter by 5 goals. So that was a great performance from both sides. And I just want to congratulations on the England team as well. It was a good first match. I'm looking forward to the next two matches.
Congratulations. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
That is Shadeen Fundamova as we now bring in Durraid Badenhorst, the coach of the SPAR Proteas. Coach, your impressions of your team's performance here today?
Thank you to England for a brilliant game. I think it was really great netball. It was tough out there. Brilliant on defence. I think we're still losing too many possession, and we really need to work on that strong drive through the middle because we stay out wide and there's no options. So yeah, we will go back and really work hard on setting a plan that the players in attack really will give stronger leads. But brilliant on certain moments. They were really great netball, and I don't want to take it away from England. They played well, but our defence were also brilliant. So, yeah, a few changes here and there, and we will be there and we will come back stronger.
Well, it did look like you were going pound for pound right up until that second half of extra time. Would you say it was a bit of lapse of concentration, tired bodies, or a combination of both?
Maybe a little bit of confidence as well. The youngsters a little bit nervous in the circle with Lefebvre there. But that's the only way that they're going to learn. And we just need to make sure that we have stronger leads and keep possession, especially in extra time.
Coach, hard luck. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
As we bring in now the coach of the England Roses, Jess Thurby. Coach, thank you very much for joining us, drawing first blood here in the three-match series.
Yeah, just about. I mean, it couldn't get much tighter. It's going to be a memorable one for myself and Durrett, I think, going to extra time. I mean, so much to work on, but a real test of character for both sides.
Well, a lot to work on, but you did pick up the victory here. What do you think the difference was between the two sides in the end?
Very little. I really do believe it was just moments. I think you saw that both teams, we were able to pull away with a few goals lead, and then South Africa Proteas pulled it back on many occasions. There were too many runs of goals against us, and that's something we're going to have to rectify for tomorrow. But I loved getting an insight into the match winners in the group, and it was great to see them really try and grind that out.
Well, that third quarter did seem to be somewhat your undoing in this game, losing that out. So what are some of the positives that you're hoping to carry into tomorrow's game?
Yeah, I just thought in those moments where we were really put under pressure by South Africa, we knew it was going to be physically really tough, and we got kind of caught up in that battle at times. I felt that we were a little bit naive in the shooting circle, and I thought Shadeen did a particularly really good job. But I felt what I was pleased with is I did see some change in that. The girls really had to work through it. I thought Fran Williams and Stacey really grew into the game in one key turnover. Laura Malcolm came on and had a really good impact. But I also felt that some of South Africa's changes at halftime caused us problems, and we were too late to react to that.
Yeah, take us through that change, because it did seem like Laura Malcolm made quite an impact on the game. What were you observing, and what is the rationale behind that?
So Laura's been training excellently, so I was confident that it was a change that I could make, as with a lot of the players on the bench. So it seemed like the right time at half time, and I think that she offers a huge amount of change of direction and change of pace and speed, but she also keeps possession of the ball really well. She's come from the defending end, so you saw that tonight. She got really key turnover for us, but I particularly thought that the goal attack that came on at half time for South Africa made a big difference for them, and that's really why we went down in that third quarter.
Coach, thank you very much and congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Great to hear from Jess and Durrett and Shadeen Fundamova as well. Just in terms of what Jess has said about Laura Malcolm, that she came on in that third quarter. We're a little bit perplexed because England lost that third quarter 17-11, and everybody out there seems pretty impressed. What are your thoughts on Laura Malcolm in that wing attack position, considering that her usual position is wing defence? She's a defender.
Yeah, and it's... You can't say that loss was purely down to Laura Malcolm in terms of...
No, but it's quite a significant gap, isn't it, in a quarter
exactly.
To lose by 17-11.
And what we saw, they were struggling to get that ball through the court and into the shooters. So that change in that centre really had a big impact on them. And I think, obviously, Laura was in that wing attack position, so had a part to play. And we do... I like her in a wing defence position because she's able to scan the game and she comes out with some amazing intercepts. And Jess touched on that, where she said she was able to be defensive in that wing attack position. But at that time, England needed an attacking wing attack.
Well, she's been brilliant, hasn't she, for Manchester Thunder in that wing defence position. Mm. It's just unusual for us to see a wing attack. Who do you like? Who's first choice for you, wing attack?
Oh, Nat Haythorn-Thwaite every day. Yeah.
Instead of goal attack for her?
I definitely think so.
She played goal attack in the last couple of quarters.
She did, and I think she's more confident in that wing attack position. She's able to, because she has played goal attack, like I said at the start, she's able to see what the shooters want. She's able to give that touch on the pass because she understands how they want to take the ball to be able to turn and shoot. So at wing attack, she's good at being that linking play between the defence coming down and then feeding into the circle.
Yeah.
Goal attack, I think she loses a little bit of space and she's not much height in there, but she does have a good shot. But wing attack, is where I would play her position. I think she can make really her own.
Centre, we saw a couple of changes. The Nat Panagari, who's been brilliant at Loughborough Lightning in that centre position. It's been quite a couple of years for Nat Panagari, hasn't it? Because she was part of the England under-17 setup, England under-19s, missed out under-21s, and has come back into the fold. How impressive have you been with her netball over the last couple of years?
Yeah, she's what's the word I'm looking for? She's underrated in terms of you never know what you're going to get with her. She just pops up. You don't assume she's
a bit of an engine, isn't she?
That's what I'm... Yeah, she's not that, like, sparky player where you'll see we'll get those amazing intercepts or this, but she gets the intercepts. They're just downplayed.
Mm.
And I think in her...
Under the radar.
That's what I was looking for.
We under the radar, don't we?
So when she's playing centre, she's just that calm presence that England needed in that last 7 minutes, in that last extra time fully, because she's able to take the ball, she's able to be collective with it, and then she's able to distribute. Mm. And that engine, as you mentioned, she just keeps going, and she'll run her other centre under the rail.
Yeah, my goodness. It was very close, wasn't it? Yeah. Going into extra time in our first match, absolutely brilliant. We can't wait to be back tomorrow. But there's so much sport coming away on Sky Sports. We're going to start with the cricket. And it's not long until they start, 9 o'clock, and they're starting early, actually, because of the rain. New Zealand, England, the second test, day two. Moving on to football, Southampton, Watford, 5 o'clock tomorrow. Super Sunday comprises of Norwich against Arsenal, that's at 1 o'clock, and Leicester, Everton at 4 o'clock. And Andy Ruiz Jr. shocked Anthony Joshua and the boxing world back in June. The rematch simply had to happen. Will it be repeat or revenge? Live coverage from Saudi Arabia gets underway next Saturday from 5 p.m. on Sky Sports Box Office. Sky customers go to channel 491 or Box Office to book this event. For more information on all the ways to watch, go to skysports.com/Joshua. Virgin Media and TalkTalk customers, please contact your operator. And we are back tomorrow, 12:30, the second test. It is South Africa, England, and on Sunday at 10:30. Arena and Mix. Pam, thanks for your company. England have won the first one. We're back tomorrow. See you then.
Sports Arena. Feel it all.